just could not imagine a scenario.
When the news broke that students, along with their parents, stormed the University of Lagos to protest the cut of marks that was imposed recently. Now, can you play that scenario in your head? Shocking, right? Well, to discuss this with Enna and I is the Director General of the Socioeconomic. Go ahead.
Executive Director
of the Socioeconomic. Yeah, very different. He is Adetokunbo Mumuni, and he is here to discuss that with us, because following this story, there's been different various conspiracy theories as to why exactly these parents went with their wards to this school, that's the University of Lagos. Now, we do know that this is on the heels of the cutoff that was reduced from 250, now 180, and even 150 for polytechnics and university colleges and colleges of education, I beg your pardon. Well, let's get into the bottom of this, because our guest today actually sued University of Lagos along with Jamb. Please tell us why.
Thank you for welcoming me here. The truth of the matter was that the students took an examination earlier. There were rules as at that time that their mind had been set to. So what happened subsequently is like now shifting the goalpost when the game has commenced. The condition and the circumstance and the facts under which the student took the examination now was changed after the initial. The expectation is that you would write the JAMB examination, thereafter cutoff mark will be set. The new thing that was introduced is that you now also offer pre-JAMB and post-JAMB examination. All of a sudden, the rule was changed to the effect that even after meeting the official cutoff mark, which would have entitled you to participate in the pre-JAMB and post-JAMB examination, the JAMB came with this system of saying, because of lack of vacancies in some federal universities in particular, then they took the liberty, without consultation with the students, without consultation with their parents, to now more or less reassign them to mind the most of the places that they were assigned were private universities.
From your narrative, sir, you've actually talked more about the timing, the factor of timing here, because what you started with is that, you know, when this law was placed, it was after the exam had already been taken.
Yes.
So your suit is not, you know, even on the subject matter why the students are not protesting, because these are two matters involved. So what will be your
As a matter of fact, it was the fact of the shifting of the goalposts when the game started that led to the protests. You see, the beginning of the protest was students wanted to online apply to write post-JAMB examination.
But are you opposed to, granted you're opposed to the nature in which this goalpost was shifted, but are you against the goalpost being shifted in the future if the right, it's followed through in terms of students knowing before they're going to sit examinations?
Then it will not be a question of shifting of goalposts again. It will not arise. Because once you let the student know...
So it should never change then?
No, what I'm saying is that if before writing the JAMB examination, you give the student the impression that we may, exercising our powers, allocate you to some other university, that is the university of your choice, that would have been okay.
Okay.
Because there is a law setting up joint admission and matriculation board as a body. There is a statute setting it up. Section 5 of that statute says JAMB has the right to organize admission into Nigerian universities, taking into consideration vacancies available, the choice in particular of the students. And that was what was breached by the subsequent change in what the student had known that they would meet on the road.
If you mention choice and if you mention, what was the first?
No, the first one is vacancies in the
vacancies,
various classes.
Exactly, yes. Because yes. That's exactly one yes. of the bone of contention here yes. for the parents and the students.
Yes.
They claim that there are vacancies, you know, within the University of Lagos, but yes. then they are not being granted that post-UTME forms to even grant them the ability to, the option of writing, taking that test. Because right now we know that Unilag, I mean, these universities, they have the option and they have their liberty to actually step up their own post-U Jamb cutoff marks, at liberty to do that.
Yes.
That's part of their issues. And then we have the issue of indigenization.
You see, the issue with the universities or the parents and the students is not that the Unilag does not have the right to raise his cutoff mark. The issue with the students is, and their parents is that we should be given the opportunity to write the post-UME examination. Once we have met the cutoff mark initially set by Jamb, if we now write the post-UME examination and we fail, there will be no issues. Because the students have a freedom of choice. It is not for you to now say, go to Crescent.
Does Unilag not have the freedom that has been granted in this act, that you've put out there?
The act relates to Jamb, and it also talks about the right of the university to set standards.
Exactly, so you've just covered that area. If it covers that area that empowers the university to actually set standards for their own organization as they deem fit, then isn't it also in their defense for Unilag to say that, oh yes, they were in a right to say that maybe there were no more vacancies?
Let me tell you.
Okay, but the students want the opportunity once they've met that cutoff point
they
to be able to
set
now.
Up, they want set by Jamb.
By Jamb.
Because that is the general body.
But is there really, is there really any point of that?
No. What I'm saying is this. When we were to write the Jamb examination itself, you told us we'll have the opportunity of writing post-Jamb examination.
Mm-hmm.
Once we are able to meet the cutoff point set by Jamb.
Separate from the university
yes.
itself. Yeah.
Uh-huh. That is the issue.
Okay.
And if you now say your own cutoff point for me to read law is 250,
so be
it is a combination of the mark that I had in Jamb and my performance at the post-UME examination combined. If it's up to 250, no, I'll go away. That is the point.
I'm standing with the defendants here.
Yes.
I'm standing with Unilag, and I'm saying, you have pointed out, you know, the clause there that covers me to say, I don't have vacancy. I don't have enough forms to accommodate everyone who has put me as a second choice or first choice to come and take that post-UME exam.
No. Let's start this way. When a match is to commence, there will be rules known to all concerned that this game that we want to start will be regulated according to these rules. The regulations are, one, write Jamb examination. Two, there will be a cutoff mark to be announced by the general body authorized to conduct matriculation examination.
Yes.
Then, after that, you will be entitled to participate in the post-UME examination.
In your school of choice.
Once you have been able to meet the cutoff mark announced by the general body, Jamb, those were the rules. And that was what, those were the things that was on the mind of the students and their parents when the students were writing Jamb.
It's very clear that you are, you're against the way, the nature in which these changes were, going to come into place. But I'm really interested to know, what is your actual opinion of the cutoff marks that Jamb, not the individual universities, Jamb has set as it stands? Because I think it's very interesting that we're looking at the fact that the cutoff point for, for if you want to study education, is at 150. But then again, we're looking at the problem, the big elephant in the room is the poor standard of education.
Let me just tell you immediately. My sincere opinion is that if you are not able to score 50% of any examination you participated in, you are not entitled to go to the university. That's my my personal opinion.
So is 150 okay?
No, if it's,
so it's
150.
200.
No, I'm talking about 150 College of Education.
Okay. No, if it is 50% of, because I think I used to know that in the College of Education it's 300 max.
It used to be. Uh-huh. Now it's 150.
It's not wow.
No, I'm what I'm saying is that the total mark.
Okay, yes, for colleges, as 400 for universities, yes.
So if out of 300 you are able to score 150,
okay.
At least that is average, 50%. Now, for the university level, the reduction of the...
There's 20% missing if you're going by
average. No, that's what I'm saying. That is even ridiculous to me.
Oh.
Okay.
My position is that if you are not able to score in any examination, leave Jamb out of it.
I totally understand, you know, you've made it clear for the past how many minutes now that you know, with the statutes that have been provided, that's exactly what the parents and the students ran with while they stormed University of Lagos. But I will still stand with the defendants. But permit me to invite the rest of the community to call in and share your thoughts. But perhaps you were part of the students that, you know, stormed Unilag to say, no, we know Gogri, or maybe not. Or you're part of the parents, then please let us know what exactly your grievances are. Because we might be misplacing it here. Some people have pinpointed indigenization is just for indigents, And then some people have said, no, it's the cutoff we're not in agreement with. Give us a call on the phone lines on your screen. You can also tweet at GMNS School TV and go on to facebook.com/GMNS School TV. Now, Mr. Adetokunbo, let me take another route to that same question. Yes. You have laid down these tenets or rules that actually guide this education system, this segment, now, if we look at it again, you would see that Unilag, as a university, they will have their own set down rules.
As a matter of fact, the law establishing JAM also gives the individual universities the right to set standards.
You agree with me?
No. It's like you.
Yes. You agree with me on that?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, our grounds is this.
Okay.
Let us know before writing the examination.
That's our general grounds.
What we will miss.
Which it seems simple.
Yes.
Simple. There's the grievance there.
That's the
not,
general.
Not the nature of the marks being changed, but in terms of where, if this is going to happen.
No, here's my where I'm, you know, I don't see eye to eye right now with you on this. I'm speaking for Unilag. They, as a body, the students have, they scored maybe about 180. They put Unilag as their second choice. And for Unilag, they don't think us as second choice. Now, I'm speaking behalf of this. Let me land. I'm speaking on behalf of some of these students that we spoke to on the phone lines. They told them, you know what, you will not get a chance to even get the form to write the post-UME exam. What is wrong with that? That, you know, Unilag is setting their own standard and sticking with it post the rules you've talked about.
No, that is even contrary to the provision of the Constitution. Mm. You see? Like when the Constitution talks in Section 36 that you must be given an opportunity to know what you will meet in any contest. There's nothing. The law in Nigeria, general law in Nigeria, does not allow ambush, if I will use that word. You see, don't get me wrong. The Jamb law, which the law that authorizes Jamb to superintend matriculation examination in Nigeria, also recognize the fact that universities are entitled to set their standard. But when you thought it was a question of picking Unilag as second choice. No. Even
some students have put that out.
No. But the real thing is that what we have been made to understand from the word go is that once you are able to meet the cutoff mark set by Jamb, you will be entitled to participate in post UME examination.
Irrespective of whether or not it's likely you will then go on to pass anyway.
Exactly.
But people just want that right to so.
Yes. Unilag can say, for you to read law with us, you must score 300 on the aggregate from your JAM and post-JAM examination.
The grievance is students want that opportunity to see if I might have only got 180 in JAM, but perhaps when I do your exam, it's possible. Combined,
so you're saying
Unilag
is wrong to say they don't get the opportunity because our farms are sold and we don't have any space. You're saying Unilag is wrong in that,
yes,
right?
Yes. Okay. Not giving them the opportunity to participate at the post-GM examination.
Okay, so that's what covers it. But did you also know, are you also aware, yeah, that, you know, in the past we've had scenarios whereby some parts of the country, you know, I won't mention, it's very obvious, whereby their cutoffs were naturally, about 10 years ago, reduced to a certain, you know, standard and level. How do we marry these two scenarios now?
You see, my sincere opinion is that once you are not able to score a minimum of 50% in an examination, going to the university, you should not go there. The reason why those people, those part of the country that you mentioned, did mm-hmm. that was to encourage people.
But isn't that double standard?
But,
oh,
no,
it reminds
me. But my position of the way they should do it is increase the quality of teaching there, increase the level of learning aids there. You understand? That way you attack the problem frontally rather than cutting standard. You see, Unilag is a federal university.
Mm.
You are talking about indigenization. No. Unilag is a federal university, open to all Nigerians. But there is always a provision of a catchment area, and it's all over Nigeria.
Mm-hmm. It's all over the world.
Yes. That this is our territory.
Mm.
Certain percentages will be reserved for people that call themselves Lagosians. The same way, University of Ibadan, certain percentages of the slot will automatically go to people that call themselves of the state.
And that's part of some people's grievance.
You see, it's also part of our concern that in the running of the affairs of Nigeria, efforts should be made not to leave any particular behind.
Okay, finally, before we let you go, we've actually run out of time. What do you aim to get with this suit? I get, you know, you've clarified the whole time backlog situation. Yeah. So what do you want out of this?
Sincerely, when you institute an action saying this has been done and you want a reversal,
okay,
and the reversal has come, you understand? That means that suit becomes spent and has been overtaken by events. So what we'll eventually do will be to withdraw the suit,
okay,
because it has now become an academic exercise. Mm-hmm. And the courts are not set up to entertain academic issues. Once it is no longer a live controversy, after the filing of the suit, the bar...
Change was made.
Mm. Yes.
All right. That's all we will be taking. We'll be getting more of your thoughts on facebook.com/GMNS School TV. But we more to say thank you to Mr. Adetokunbo Mumuni, who is the executive director of the Social Economic Rights Accountability Project. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
So many suits you have to deal with. You have the one against... we'll not talk about it. Let's move on. We have entertainment up next on the Good Morning Nigeria Show. Do stay with us.
So, did you like what you just saw?
I know you did.
Mm-hmm. It's very simple. If you want to see more, just subscribe to our channel right now.